Okay, so this time let's now have an example regarding the Bernoulli and the continuity equation. So our problem here is that the water flowing at a rate of 2 cubic meter per second through a tube with a diameter of 1 meter. So there is a water flowing through a tube. If the pressure at this point is 80 kPa, then what's the pressure at of the water after the tube narrows to a diameter of 0.5 meter. So before we solve, let's now simplify this problem by having an illustration or kahit a very simple illustration lang just to show our or just to visualize our problem. So let's say we have here a pipe. So let's say this is a pipe. So at point 1, the water flows. So let's say this is your pipe and there's water flowing inside it. Okay. So the flow rate Q, our symbol for our flow rate is Q. Q is just 2 cubic meter per second. So the diameter of the first side of the tube is 1 meter. So we have a diameter of 1 meter here. And then if the pressure at this point is 80 kPa, so let's say this is a pressure 1, at point 1, we have 80 kPa or kilopascal. And then, what is the pressure of the water after the tube narrows? So, after the tube narrows, what will be then our new pressure? So, this is our unknown. What will be the pressure if the tube narrows to a diameter of 0.5 meters? So, parang lumiit siya. So, lumiit yung diameter. So, what will happen to the pressure inside this tube? So this is now our point 2. So remember, the water flowing is just 2 cubic meter per second. So based from this, we want to determine the pressure. So using our Bernoulli equation, we can now determine our pressure 2 here. Okay? So from Bernoulli, we have P1 plus 1 half density of our liquid, which is our water. So it's the liquid flowing here is water. So the density we must use is the density of the water, which is 1000 kilogram per cubic meter. Density, gravity, h is the elevation or the height of this pipe, and then is equal to our unknown plus the pressure at point 2 plus 1 half density velocity squared plus density gravity h2. Okay. So based on this, as you can notice, it always says that point 1 must be equal to point 2. Okay. As well as for our continuity equation, point 1 flow at point 1 is equal to flow at point 2. Okay. So from here, we have P1 already. And then density is given, but our velocity is, we don't know what is the velocity. Okay. And based from here, let's say the pipe is at zero datum, so this is your reference point. I mean, let's assume this na as a level lang siya, as a ground, so there's our h here is just zero, so we can now cancel out this 2. But if your problem is just, for example, point 1 is there's an elevation from point 1 to point 2, then you must consider the h, okay, the value of your h. But in this problem, our h is just zero, so we can now cancel out this equation here. So again, we are given by p density, but we don't know the V. As well as here, we don't know the P, this is unknown, and we also don't know the value of our velocity here. But from our continuity equation, we can now solve the value of our V, isn't it? So we see that Q is equal to AV. So we have Q1 is equal to Q2. So our Q1 here is equal to A1 V1. So from based on your continuity equation, we have your Q is equal to AV. So at point 1, our Q is 2 cubic meter per second. Our A is the area given by this diameter. So area of the circle is just pi d squared over 4. So yung d natin ay diameter is 1 pi d squared all over 4. So this is our A times your velocity at this point. So from here we can now compute the value of your V1. So using your calculator, you can now solve for the value of V1, which is 2.55 meter per second. So the same process will be also used to find the velocity at point 2. So Q again is equal to AV. So let's directly substituting our values like this, you can do the algebra so to find B. So from here we have B is equal to, divide both sides by A, we have now Q all over A, and then our B is equal to our Q divide our A, it's just our area is pi d squared all over 4. Okay, so from here we can now compute the value of your V2. So the value of your V2 is just the Q, 2 cubic meter per second squared. I, your D, now at point 2 is 0.5. So D squared, so this is squared, 0.5 squared, divided by 4. So your V2 is just equal to, it's just 10.19, and what is our unit? We have here meter square, so meter 1, so we have meter per second. So our V1 is 2.55, our V2 is 10.19. So our V1 here is 0.55, our V2 here is 10.19. So now we can now compute for the value of our V2 here. So from our Bernoulli, we now have V1 plus 1/2 density V1 squared is equal to V2 plus 1/2 density V2 squared. So to compute for the value of V2, let's now move this 1/2 density V2 squared to the other side. So we have V1 plus 1/2 density V1 squared minus 1/2 density V2 squared. Okay. So for the value of V2, we have our P1 is just 80 kPa. Plus 1/2, our density is equal to 1,000 kilogram per cubic meter, times our V1 is just 2.55 meter per second squared minus 1/2 density, again kilogram cubic meter, times our velocity at 2 is 10.19 meter per second. Okay, so from here this term is just equal to 3251.25. So our value, our unit is just kilogram per cubic meter, meter square per second square. Since this term is square, so you must square the meter and the also the second square. Minus 51,918.05. So our unit is just the same. Kilogram, meter cube, meter square, second square. Okay. So,